Hi guys, in today's video we are going to see History and Indian Constitution Paper 2 question paper of APBSC Group 1. So 3 hours of time, maximum marks is 150 and the question paper will be in 3 sets and the candidate has to answer 15 questions with 5 questions each session. Okay, so here we have 3 sections. From each sections we have 5 questions. Again, in that 5 questions, we have internal choice A or B. Now, look at the questions. In section A, compare Hinaya and Mahayana Buddhism. Why did Buddhism become popular and decline subsequently? Or, what are the important features of major schools of art that flourished during modern period? You can choose either one of them and you can answer. Second question. Describe major contributions of great Mughals to Indian architecture or what is the cultural contribution of Vijayanagar Empire? Moving on. The period between 1885 to 1905 is a period of moderates in Indian freedom struggle. In the light of above statement, describe the contribution of early nationalist moderates in organizing the national movement. You can write this or describe the nature and significance of revolt of 1857. Explain whether it can be termed as the first war of independence. Next question. Here I'm just reading out the questions to give you an information about what questions been asked in the previous paper. Next, comment on the effectiveness of the methods employed by Mahatma Gandhi to mobilize masses. The effectiveness. Next, we must hold fast to constitutional methods for achieving our social economical objectives. Briefly explain the significance of this statement of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar with reference to his achievements. Also explain its relevance in the present to protect democracy. Quiet points can be written for this answer. You can. I'm moving on to this next question. So here if you notice in the regional language Telugu and English also been asked. So, people who opted for Telugu, they can read out the Telugu question and they can answer in Telugu. Fifth question, comment on the contribution of peasant movements in freedom struggle or analyze the role of communalism in the partition of the country. So, these are the 10 questions which has been asked in the session 1. Moving on to the section 2, briefly describe political fortunes or cultural contribution of Ikshuas or describe the contribution of Eastern Chalukyas to literature, art and architecture. Either one. Seventh question. Comment on the contribution of Qutub Shahis to Telugu language and literature or write about poet Molla, her work and style. Most probably you can go with this. Next question. Comment on the contribution of literary works of Gurram Joshua in social reform or illustrate the salient features of literacy works of Dr. Boy Bhimanna. So, what are the salient features of literary works of Dr. Boy Bhimanna? Ninth question. Describe the contribution of Andhra Mahasabha in socio-cultural development or describe Vande Mataram movement and its impact on freedom struggle in Andhra Pradesh. In 10th question, trace the reasons for success and subsequent failure of Telangana people's armed struggle or who are Rajakars and what was their role in resisting integration of Hyderabad state in Indian Union. Rajakars and their role. So these are the 10 questions which has been asked in section 2. Moving on to section 3, 11th question. The Indian constitution is federal in form but unitary in spirit. Discuss. So who have given the statement, the background of the statement, everything in detail. But remember we have 3 hours of time and 15 questions to be answered. So each question 15 10 marks. So accordingly prepare and note down the time in mind and then answer. Analyze the effectiveness of implementation of directive principles of state policy and suggest ways to improve it. Either one you can choose an answer. 12th question. What is the concept of cooperative federalism? Does it exist in Indian polity? Or comment briefly on the financial relations between the union and the states in India. What are iterants generally encounter? Guys, whoever are preparing, think whether you can answer these questions. Do you at least have a minimum concept knowledge of these questions or not? When I'm reading out a question, think the background, what it is, when it started, from where it started, who have initiated it, who have propagated this all. So think clearly, do you have an idea of it? Do you have any suggestions on it? Any kind of sessions you know about it? Any kind of history you know about it? On whom, which period this issue has happened? So think properly and test yourself how much you are currently in your knowledge. Moving on to the 12th question. What is concept of cooperative federalism? Does it exist in Indian polity? When I say cooperative federalism, first think of what does this cooperative federalism term means. So you have to be like that. You should think. Next, comment briefly on the financial relations between the union and states in India. What are iterants generally encountered? Moving on. What is meant by judicial activism? What its impact on Indian polity? Judicial activism. When I say this term, you must go back immediately and go and think in your mind, like, what does this term means? When does it come into existence? From where this term has been come up? What period this issue has been started? Think in that way. Next, what is the relative position of Rajya Sabha as compared to the Lok Sabha in our political system? What is the relative position? How it's impacting? Next. Describe the procedure for amending the constitution. What is the criticism against it? Or what according to the Supreme Court constitute the basic structure of our constitution? Name a couple of important judgments of the Supreme Court on this issue. Okay. 15th question. Describe the various special provisions in the constitution relating to scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, backward classes and Anglo-Indians. What are the special provisions? Or explain the concept of minorities with reference to Indian constitution and the safeguards available for protection of their rights. Got it? So these are the 30 questions which have been asked in the previous year of history paper. And when I go through, when I read it, think of how much you are aware of the terms, ideology, what are the periods that happen. So this is how it is. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be sharing new papers in the upcoming videos. And do subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Have a great day and good luck for your preparation, guys.